Welcome to Fear No Evil. The evil that I will be speaking about today is the sexual allegations that are in the mainstream media still. We have a new candidate, Matt Lauer, from one of the morning programs. Everybody knows who he is. If you've been watching any morning programs for at least 20 years now. I find it interesting that he, too, says that he is sorry. He's very, very sorry. Al said he was sorry. Harvey said he was sorry. And some of these women are accepting the apology. A true survivor may accept the apology, but they're not going to give any kind of indication that it's okay. Just because you accept the apology does not make the damage okay. Anyone who has been sexually violated, truly, they are changed. Their life is never the same. And they will struggle for the rest of their life trying to find out who they are after the abuse. This is very different from the child who is sexually abused as a child. They're trying to figure out who they are, knowing that they've been abused and that it has done damage to their body, to their life, to how they feel about themselves and the world. And they will be unearthing and discovering those changes for the rest of their lives. So the fact that these people who have money and power and position want to say they're sorry and then get whisked off to some place where they think they're going to get treatment is a fallacy, because we can't even treat the pedophile or this child molester in our community without having to constantly put them under surveillance. So the fact that these people think they're going to whisk off into the sunset somewhere, making everyone believe that they're actually getting treatment, it really is a lie. Because we don't know how to treat people who commit sexual violations. So the fact that they're saying they're sorry and that women are accepting this is setting a really bad precedent for the children who are being sexually abused. And it's setting a really bad precedent for those who are being violated right now, or for those who lost their jobs because they did say something. People think that when children come out and say they're being sexually abused by a family member, or maybe someone who's close to the family, they think that the family stands behind these children. They do not. The children are usually quite by themselves, abandoned by their family, abandoned by people that they know. And they are cloaked with this coat of shame, instead of having the support that they need. Now people also think that support comes from the courthouses, the prosecutors, DSS workers. You're wrong in that instance too. Many victims are re-victimized as they have to go through these different agencies trying to get the help that they need. And for the most part, they don't get the help that they need. And that's why many people don't say anything, because they do not get the help that they need. America really needs to take this seriously. We start with allegations of pedophilia. Harvey Weinstein has allegations of sexual trafficking. Al Franken has a picture of him actually touching somebody's breasts. We have Conyers walking around in his underwear. And now we have Matt with his allegations. If these allegations were in a court room, they would be called sexual crimes. They'd be charged with a sexual crime. But I find it interesting that all these women are coming out now past their statute of limitations. Therefore, these cases will never be in court. So we cannot say whether these allegations are true or not. They're not in the courtroom. So the media, who thinks that they're standing on their soapbox, there's not one news media station that doesn't have sexual allegations running through them. So I find it very interesting that the media is going to stand up now and be the moral superiors of this issue, when these women really need to sit down and they really need to shut up, because a lot of women knew this was going on. A lot of women allowed this was going on. Women gossip about other men all the time. That's why when President Trump came out with what he said, women were aghast. Are you serious? Women have said worse things. I'm a woman. I've sat in those conversations. And they weren't all conservative women. So the fact that the liberals want to make it look like it's the conservatives who allow this to go on. It's the conservatives who aren't saying a word, but we're going to stand up and say something. Please, America, don't buy their agenda. Don't buy their BS from Fox News all the way down. Do not buy it. Because women are going to be the first ones to tell another woman about a man. But they think they're weak, too weak to actually bring a case to the courtroom. We have enough women lawyers out here that they could have went to any woman lawyer, presented their case, and brought it to the courtroom. But now they want to do it in the public arena. Well, the public arena knows nothing much about childhood sexual abuse, pedophilia, child sexual trafficking, all of these things. They're not educated enough. So the public certainly aren't the ones to say whether these allegations are true or whether they are false. So I'm just letting the main media know that your lies will not be tolerated any longer. And your stance for feminism is a crock. And the fact that you want to be out in the forefront trying to lead other women, you need to sit down. And if America really wants to lead, they'll lead on this topic. Why? Because this is a global problem. There are children everywhere in every country who need to be liberated from sexual trafficking, being sold into marriage, being sold for sex slaves. We have a $1 billion business of pornography in our own country. We have a problem, America, with child sexual abuse. And until we really get serious with the issues, until everyone begins to speak about it, and not just liberals speak about it, because it affects everybody, we are getting nowhere. And if the people on the other side really want to think that they're the moral superiors of this issue, that they're the women who are going to lead this issue, I don't think so. The women who are going to lead this issue are the sexual abuse survivors themselves. And if you are not one, I suggest that you sit down and that you listen to the ones who are.